Large telescopes in astronomy have been getting bigger over time, since astronomers are interested in getting the greatest light gathering power and the best resolution. However, there are substantial challenges in making large mirrors. Mirror making has traditionally begun with a mirror blank, a cylindrical piece of glass or ceramic with low thermal expansion. The blank is ground so that the optical surface has the correct curvature. This is by far the biggest chunk of work. The optical surface is then polished to be very smooth. Lastly, a reflective aluminum coating is applied. In the early 1980s, Stewart Observatory Mirror Lab at the University of Arizona began using the technique of spin casting. This involves creating the mirror blank in nearly the correct parabolic shape in a spin caster that is a combination of oven and mirror ground. Chunks of glass, similar to Pyrex, are heated in the device and once molten, are rotated at a precisely calculated rate. Centrifugal forces produce a parabolic shape, and then the mirror blank is cooled and allowed to solidify while still rotating. This greatly reduces the labor needed to grind the mirror into the final correct parabolic shape. The following demonstration is useful for conveying how spin casting works. It consists of a thin rectangular tank, think fish tank, that is mounted on an electric motor that will allow it to rotate. A liquid is needed to represent liquid glass, and we will use water with a little green food coloring for visibility. Imagine that there is a built-in furnace, and temperature will be conveyed by a red glow. We can think of this as a slice of the normal spin casting process. We begin spin casting at room temperature with no rotation. Our glass is a rectangular slab. We then raise the temperature until the glass becomes molten, and then turn on the rotation. Note that our liquid quickly assumes a parabolic shape. We now turn off the heat and allow the glass to slowly cool and solidify in this shape. More teaching materials can be found on the web at astro.unl.edu.